I watch the film, the song remains the same. At the midnight movies when I was a kid. At a Canton, Ohio mall with friends. One warm summer weekend. Jimmy Page stood tall on screen. And I was mesmerized by everything. The Peter Grant and John Paul Jones dream sequence scenes. The close-up of the mahogany double-neck SG. And though I love the sound of the roaring Les Paul, what spoke to me most was Rain Song and Bronya. And I love the thunder of John Bonham's drums. But even more, I like No Quarters Low Fender Rhodes hum. I don't know what happened or what anyone did. From my earliest memories, I was a very melancholic kid. When anything close to me at all in the world died, to my heart forever it would be tied. Like when my friend was thrown from his moped, when some kind of a big truck back-ended. And when the girl who sat in front of me in Remedial was killed in an accident one weekend and quickly forgotten about at school. And when we got the call that my grandmother passed, the nervous tension I'd been feeling for months broke, and strangely I laughed. Then I went to my bedroom and I laid down. And in my tears and in the heaviness of everything I drowned. I kept to myself and for the most part was pretty coy. I once got baited into clocking some undeserving boy. Out on the elementary school playground, I threw a punch that caught him off guard and knocked him down. And when I walked away, the kids were cheering. And though I grinned, deep inside I was hurting. But not nearly as much as I'd hurt him. He stood up, his glasses broken, and his face was red. And I was never a schoolyard bully. It was only one incident, and it has always eaten. I was never a young schoolyard bully. And wherever you are, that poor kid, I'm so sorry. When I grew older, I learned to play guitar. While everyone else was throwing around a football. wearing bright colors, the school issued them, parroting passed down phrases and cheerleading. I got a recording contract in 1992. From there, my name and my band and my audience grew. And since that time, so much has happened to me. But I discovered I cannot shake melancholy. For 46 years now, I cannot break the spell. I'll carry it throughout my life and probably carry it to hell. I'll go to my grave with my melancholy, and my ghost will echo my sentiments for all eternity. Now when I watch, the song remains the same things speak to me that spoke to me then. Except now the scenes with Peter Grant and John Bonham are different when I think about the dust that fell upon them. I got a friend who lives in the desert outside Santa Fe, and I'm going to visit him Saturday. Between my traveling, his divorces, and our time not being what it was, it's been 15 years since I last saw him. He's a man who signed me back in 92, and I'm gonna go there and tell him face to face, thank you. For discovering my talent so early, for helping me along in this beautiful musical world I was meant to be.